If you've had a difficult, challenging, or even a bad day, there is always tomorrow. Tomorrow is another day. When you have had a challenging, difficult, or even a bad day, remember tomorrow is another day. Hello, you all. I'm Diana Brianne. Well, please ignore my messy kitchen. I've had a very, very busy day. And so I want to tell you about my day, and then I would love to hear about your day too. Well, my day was pretty much involved with my schoolwork. As most of you know, I'm 62 years old and I went back to college last semester. I'm taking more than full-time classes, and for me, some of them are advanced. And so I have this one class, it's really, 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 really hard. And yesterday, I was really having a struggle with it. And even though I go in-person classes, much of our work is still done online at home. And so I had all this homework and everything. And so I was kind of frustrated yesterday with my schoolwork. And I felt, I don't want to say overwhelmed because I don't let myself get overwhelmed, but I felt just a little bit frustrated with it. And so today I spent a large amount of time with that particular subject. And I have to tell you, I did really, really, really well. And that's how this ties into the subject is tomorrow is another day. Because yesterday I was so frustrated and I went to bed last night and I said, you know what? I'm just going to remember that tomorrow is another day. And so today after I got up, after I did my 5-mile run, I put my attention on my schoolwork and I did it very, very slow in order to focus on it. And I will have to tell you what my grade is. Well, I took an online test tonight, which is usually how we take our tests, even though we go in person. And it was a big test. It was a hard test. And I took a long, long time on it. And I only missed one. I got a 96. Yay! I got a 96 and I was so excited because it was such a very, very, very hard test. So I'm happy, I'm happy. So that really does tie in with tomorrow is another day. We have to remember when we've had a challenging, difficult, or even a bad day, we have to remember that we need to stay consistent with our positive attitude, our positive choices and decisions. And if we do, eventually we're going to have tomorrow, and tomorrow will be another day. And generally speaking, things do turn around. And so I believe that when we give our very best, even during the challenging times, and remember that tomorrow is another day, that things will work out for your benefit. Whereas if you get negative and throw in the towel, well, if you throw in the towel on something, that ends it. And so then what do you have? So sometimes we just have to hang in there and stick in there. I often talk about the story about good old Don. Now, good old Don is a guy that my husband and I both knew many, many years ago. And he was always having one challenge after the other in his career. And so did everybody else who was in his same career. And yet, good old Don hung in there. He stayed with it. He stuck to it. Every day he got up, he went to work. He just gave his very best. And he continued on. As many of his peer group began to drop off from that profession, he hung in there. And today he's very successful as a result many, many years later. Good old Don. And so that's kind of my attitude with my schoolwork. I just hang in there. I keep in there. And so if you've had a challenging day at work or a challenging day in your family or a challenging day in your marriage or a challenging day in anything, remember there's always tomorrow, there's always next week, there's always next month, and there's always next year. And the key to it is to keep giving positive attitude, positive choices, positive decisions, and stay consistent with those in order for things to work out towards your benefit. And so that's what I did. I got up today and I said, oh, I don't want to do this again, but I did. And I really, really focused. And but I did get my exercise in. Didn't go to the gym because, well, you know, with all that's going on in the news right now, I'm kind of staying away from the gym and staying away from most big social gatherings. And so, but I went for a run on my trail, and that was wonderful. And then my son and I went out to the store. Although we're all stocked up on groceries and everything that we need, I wanted to see and get a little bit more. And when we went out there, I was amazed. It was packed. The store was absolutely packed. Half of the shelves were empty. And the toilet paper, of all things, was totally gone. There was not even one roll of toilet paper. I mean, what is up with the toilet paper? I don't understand it. And, you know, I guess it's, you know, people are getting prepared, you know, for whatever, you know, whatever it may be. And I think that's a good idea, preparation. I'm very prepared type of person. But that's a whole nother video that I'll do about preparation in life. And, you know, I got to thinking about tsunamis. You know, if someone told me that a tsunami was coming and I couldn't see it, and so I might not believe it. And yet, just because I don't see it doesn't mean it can't happen. And so if I'm sitting on a beach, I'm likely going to move quite a ways inward, so I'm not affected by the tsunami. And if it doesn't happen, that's great. That's great. So I'm not saying a tsunami is coming. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just using that as an example that sometimes preparation is really good. And you know, I think that's what people are doing at the grocery store and that. So I'm well stocked up and all that. So I came home, put my stuff away, and got back into the books. And so now I'm tired, but it's a good tired, And so my kitchen's messy, got to clean it up. And I think tomorrow I'll get up and I'll go for my run, sit out on grandma's porch a little bit. And, you know, just enjoy. So remember, tomorrow is another day. So if you've had a tough day, a tough week, a tough month, a tough year, remember there's always another day, always another week, always another month, and always another year. Keep your choices, your decisions positive, and keep them consistent. Well, from my house to yours, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you all soon again. Bye-bye.